Hi, I'm Dr. Gail Cresci, and I'm staff and an associate professor in the Department of Gastroenterology, Hepatology, and Nutrition at the Cleveland Clinic, where I'm a registered dietitian and a researcher. What is a fecal transplant? A fecal microbiota transplant is a medical procedure, and what happens is there's healthy stool that's obtained from a donor, and this gets transplanted into someone that has unhealthy stool or a diseased colon. So what's important to know is that our gut is full of microbes, both good and bad. But there can be circumstances where the bad microbes overtake the good microbes. A fecal transplant can be a way to reestablish a healthy gut microbiome profile. What diseases can a fecal transplant treat? A fecal transplant is recommended and proven to be effective only as a treatment for persistent Clostridium difficile, or otherwise known as C. diff, infection, when antibiotics don't work anymore. Now, there are research studies going on to see if fecal transplant could be effective for other conditions, such as inflammatory bowel disease, irritable bowel syndrome, obesity for weight loss, people with different liver diseases, diabetes, food allergies, and even multiple sclerosis. How does a fecal transplant work? So there's several steps to having a fecal transplant. First step is that a healthy stool sample is obtained from a healthy donor. Then this stool sample is screened for any potential infections or other diseases. After the stool sample is collected, about 50 grams is sent to the lab for processing. Then the recipient of the fecal transplant must undergo a colonoscopy prep. So like the prep you do for, you know, just a standard colonoscopy. Then there are four possible methods for providing the fecal transplant to the recipient. One could be through a colonoscopy procedure. The other could be upper endoscopy procedure, or the person may receive an enema, or there are now fecal stool capsules that are available that a person would swallow, and then that would restore the microbiome. What are the risks of a fecal transplant? So like any procedure, there are some risks to receiving a fecal transplant. Some risks could be mild to moderate GI symptoms, such as bloating, gas, nausea, vomiting, or abdominal discomfort. Others are possible fever or chills that may occur a couple days after the procedure. There is still a remote risk of transferring a harmful pathogen to the recipient, and that because there's not standardized protocols for screening and processing of the sample and delivery to the recipient, it's impossible to guarantee the safety of all fecal transplant procedures. What are the benefits of a fecal transplant? It can help reestablish a healthy gut microbiome that can stand up to C. diff when antibiotics don't work anymore, and then it's able to restore a healthy gut microbiome balance. And actually, the fecal transplant has shown to be 80 to 95% effective in preventing recurrence of C. difficile infection, which represents a breakthrough in the treatment for recurrent Clostridium difficile infections.